this is Sean Hess. I'm the broker manager of St. Augustine Team Realty in St. Augustine, Florida. And this is...
I'm Kate Stevens, Sean's business partner.
And broker associate and business partner. And these are the five biggest problems with realtors and their solutions. If you're buying or selling a house, you may work with a realtor. If you're in real estate, you work with realtors all the time. And some realtors have problems. And so these are some of the things that we've noticed as realtors ourselves and present some possible solutions for you. So I'm going to go with, we kind of came up with five. There's communication and miscommunication are probably the two biggest two. So I'm going to start with communication and let Kate handle miscommunication. But communication is, they never return your phone calls. They don't return your emails. Now, here's the thing you have to consider, and only you will know this. Is it a realtor problem or is it a you problem? And by that, I mean, are they not returning your phone calls in 24 hours or are they not returning your phone calls in 24 minutes? We had my partner, our business partner, Ron, last week. We were at a charity auction last Friday, and Ron has a closing, I think, in a week or two. And the agent for that closing called him and couldn't get in touch with him because he was in a charity auction. I was here at the office. So the person called Kate. And Kate told her, he's at a charity auction, will get right back to you. And I was just going over there, so I'm like, well, I'll tell Ron this person's trying to get in touch with him. So from the time I drove here to the charity auction, about 10 minutes, the person had called Ron four times, and Ron was in the middle of a charity auction. So, you know, I wouldn't say that was a communication problem on Ron's part. I just think that was an agent who just, you know, come on, man.
Well, and there are times, you know, sometimes I have some people, and it seems to me, where who always say, gosh, I always get your voicemail, because a large portion of what I do all day is on the phone. So,
correct.
You know, you will, but I will call you back. I'll call you right back. And, you know, if you're somebody that I really, really need to talk to, I'm in the middle of a crisis, and I will bump out the call before, but just, you know,
yeah, and that too, or text,
on.
You know,
occasionally you're in areas with no signal.
But the issue is, are there really realtors who don't get back within 24 hours or 48 hours? I had one of those yesterday. I had called for showing instructions, and I finally got the emailed. I used every means. There were four means available to actually make a showing appointment. Through two different MLS systems, I could set up a showing through their computer system, but I needed a code. I left two messages. The guy's cell phone message said the cell phone is now broken. 26 hours later, he gets back to me with the code. It's, you know, that would have been great 24 hours ago. I called someone on 7 o'clock on a Saturday night and I didn't hear from him on Sunday because maybe he's out with his family, that's understandable. But during a business day where I call at 1 o'clock and don't hear until 3 o'clock the next day, that's unacceptable. In that case, if you can and are not under contract, you can dump your realtor. But not if you're under contract because you're pretty much stuck with them then. You want to handle miscommunication?
Well, miscommunication, that can be...
So that was the solution. Dump your realtor if they don't get back to you. But make sure it's a problem before you do that.
Miscommunication can be between a number of parties. It can be sort of, especially if it's a contract that this is a little bit tricky, it's got some maybe financing issues or some repair things, or you've got, for whatever reason, the buyers and the sellers are not really sort of comfortable with each other. The miscommunication, it's very important that things are communicated clearly and in a timely manner, and that important pieces of information aren't omitted, because you know that makes the phone call a bit more difficult. So miscommunication is really somebody putting their own slant on the facts and relaying them. Realtors tend to have a little bit of a reputation for always putting a positive spin on everything, and that's not always the best. You know, sometimes people want to hear if there are really problems, because the sooner they hear it, the less surprised they are when 3 days before closing there are issues.
Correct.
So miscommunication
like
can be
payment or something like that.
You know, and I don't mean in a misleading way, but sometimes people don't want to tell people bad news or difficult things, or they think that it might get better in the next few days. But my experience has always been it's best to keep everybody on board and with the latest updates. And
we'll put it another way. It's like a mortgage broker says you can't spend more than $200,000. The realtor talks to the mortgage agent. The mortgage agent says this person cannot go above $200,000. The buyer calls the agent and says the mortgage person says we need to start at $200,000. Okay, that's miscommunication. That's someone, you know, and the realtor's caught in the middle of that. So They want to go look at houses that are $220,000 or $240,000 and then make a $200,000 offer. And when they should really maybe be looking at $180,000 houses that are $210,000. And that's a miscommunication issue. It's just something that has to be solved as much as possible up front. And the only solution to miscommunication is communication, good, just talking like Kate said.
Well, I'm trying to be impartial, trying not to, you know, sometimes, you know, there are people involved in every real estate transaction, which means that there are personalities and different personality types involved. And the miscommunication can sometimes be, you know, it's skewed in favor of one of the stronger mm-hmm. opinions or one of the stronger parties, or it's skewed in a positive way or skewed in a very negative way. So it's just trying to be impartial and rational about things rather than put everybody's spin on everything and kind of sort of get the message across.
This even actually leads to number five too, which is not listening to what you want, or a complaint about realtors that they don't listen to what we want.
I mean, we've worked with buyers that have found their way to us mm-hmm. who were previously working with agents who just said, all they ever did was show me their own listings. All they ever did was show me their office listings.
Yeah.
All they ever did was, they didn't listen to what I said. They steered us in a way that we didn't feel we were looking at houses that were what we wanted in our price range.
And the reason why we end up with them is because the buyer fired them because they didn't listen to what their price range is. But also, if it gets back to the mortgage broker saying you can only go up to $200,000 and you want to start looking at $240,000 and we're not listening to what you want, or the realtor's not listening to what you want because they're only showing you what the mortgage person says you can afford, you know, that's a communication issue that you just have to break down. And sometimes it means the buyer walks from us, and that's okay because, well, you know.